going to be seeing these small Python programs that we are going to complete in order for us to be able to build our skill in Python, including in Python. So we are going to be seeing as much as possible. There are 20 of them here. Then we are going to be seeing, like, calculating the area of a square, you know, checking if a string is a palindrome or not, and checking about whether you convert a string to uppercase or lowercase, calculate the sum of given numbers, check if a given string is a given number is even or odd. So we are going to do all that and more. You can see I've listed them on the screen. So guys, before we continue, I am Nash and I'm going to be your instructor throughout this Python course. So first one we are having in our list is write a Python program to print hello world. To print hello world, the only thing you need to do is just a one line code. This is the only line code to print hello world. You see, Python is very, very important, very, very beautiful because it has fewer lines of code and it's very, very clear, straightforward. So if you want to do the first thing when you want to learn how to learn a Python program or any programming, you know, the first thing here is to know how to learn how to print. I will use a print function. This is just a print function that we are using to be able to do what? To print the word hello world. And when I run this particular, when I run this, it prints on the terminal, hello world. That is it. You see where our output is hello world. So now you now know how to print something. To print something with in Python, right? In Python programming. Now let's go to the next one. The next one that we are going to be seeing here is. So the next one we are seeing is write a Python program to calculate the sum of two numbers entered by the users. Sum of two numbers that is entered by the user. So for the, this is it. For the two number entered by the user, the first thing I'm going to do is I have to declare. I know there are two numbers that are entered by the user. I want to get those numbers from the users. I'm just going to choose a variable that is called num1. It can be anything depending on you. So just based on what I'm doing, I just say num1, which is going to be holding what the number, the first number that the user is going to be entering. So I'm passing an input function to take the number from the users, and I'm passing it. I'm converting it. I'm typecasting it to be a float. I want it to be a float so that the users can enter a decimal point number and can enter an integer number also. So that is why I've put a float here so they can accept both decimal and integer numbers. So this variable is holding the first number. This num1 variable is holding the first number the user is going to enter. I declare another variable and I'm assigning to it the second number that the user is going to also enter. And then I'm declaring the third variable that is going to hold the sum of num1 and num2. This variable is going to hold the sum of these two numbers that the user has already entered. So, which is going to be what? There's, I just say result is equals to. So, I assign to it num1 and num2 because num1 is holding the first. This num1 variable is holding the first number that the input the user has entered. The num2 variable is holding the second number the user has entered. And then the print, I'm printing. Remember, we always print. To get the output, you must always use a print function. You get it for us to get it at the terminal, to print it out at the terminal. So,